Hi, my name is Lisa Ackerman, and I am an associate conservator here at the Art Institute of Chicago. The space we're in is the Objects Conservation Department. It's where we condition check and treat works of art that are three-dimensional. I stumbled upon art conservation while I was investigating graduate programs. It took a few different jobs before I decided that this was a career path that I was really, really interested in. One of the few schools that teach art conservation was located right in my backyard. So I went to check it out, and the rest is history. On a day-to-day basis, there's a lot of documentation. We do investigations into materials and trying to understand the history of an object, whether it's been treated in the past, if there's been any repairs made, different surface coatings applied, areas that were touched up. Everything gets documented. We use normal illumination first and foremost to document the physical features of every object that comes through here. And then we do detail shots of any issues. Then we do an investigation of the surfaces. We start off with ultraviolet illumination, which can show us where there's overpaint, where there's a different type of surface coating on an area. Sometimes it's obvious with the naked eye because a lot of older surface coatings that may have been put on a repair may start to yellow over time, but we can see a lot of that in UV. On the electromagnetic spectrum, UV radiates at shorter wavelengths than visible light and cannot be seen by the human eye. But when UV comes in contact with certain materials, it's reflected back towards the eye at longer wavelengths, or visible light. This phenomenon is known as fluorescence. Industrial black lights have been made to be able to help us with illuminating UV in a way that it can make materials either fluoresce, or sometimes they absorb the light and you don't see any fluorescence whatsoever. Today we're going to talk about UV and how we use it at the Art Institute and in conservation to examine art objects. This is an art object. It looks fairly normal as a piece of furniture underneath regular light, but here I can give you an example of how UV can show us other things. This was originally painted in gilt and was likely given an oil varnish. Under UV, this area fluoresces orange, and there are smatterings of orange throughout the object. So what I want to do is remove shellac and overpaint that has been added over the original so we can see more of this emblem. So when I look at the image in UV, I see something is different, and I can go to the piece itself and look at where I suspect something has been done, and then reevaluate it going back and forth between regular light and UV.
Mm-hmm. When UV light hits an object, how come it glows? Why does it glow?
So not everything does glow. Basically, when UV hits a material, it stimulates the energy of that material. That higher energy is what creates that visible fluorescence back at us. Here we're set up for, we've got our normal illumination, and then we have our UV lights in those towers. If you don't mind hitting that light switch over there, I'm going to open the UV, shut off these, so we can open up the photo that we just took, which is this one.
How come the cracks are glowing?
Because there's adhesive in those. And the adhesive is fluorescing back in this whitish color. So where it's darker, that is where the glaze is. Where it's brighter, that is where there's overpaint or repairs that have been made. So a good bit of this has been repaired. For me, the most exciting part is when it's something that makes the treatment more obvious. I specialize in wooden artifacts and furniture, so I deal a lot with previous coatings, and I definitely don't want to remove something that's original. Sometimes there can be a lot going on, and it can be very confusing as to what's original and what's not. So we really need to be careful. It's really cool also to see techniques, and sometimes you can see a fingerprint or something like that in the original coating, and that's always exciting. The favorite part of my job is doing the after treatment photos, especially when you're happy with the way the treatment went. The satisfaction of finishing the project and knowing that you did it well. I love the fact that it's an ongoing learning process. You never feel like you know everything. You will never know everything. And it's constantly evolving and changing. And no matter what your career thoughts are, you should really just do a lot of investigation. Go out and talk to people. There's plenty of opportunities to come into the labs, come into a museum and ask to speak with conservation or science. Just don't be afraid to reach out and learn about your career possibilities as much as possible. Do not be afraid of the science. We don't have enough scientists, I think, in this country, and we don't have enough people who are really passionate about their job in this country. You know, if you love your job, you never work a day in your life, and it's a pleasure for me to come to work every day and do something that I really love to do.